Ladies and gentlemen, it's Late Night Binder, a variety show.
Halloween!
Starring Pure and Weary, Bibik, Matt Ulrich, Sam Brown, Sarah O'Dwyer, Andria Emerick, Nicole Bowles, Linda Rudy, and Amee. Late Night Binder. Welcome to Late Night Binder. That's me, a Halloween variety show. And boy, do we have a variety for you.
Now, you may recognize some familiar faces if you saw the first episode of Late Night Binder. And if you didn't, well, grab yourself a big bowl of candy corn and get ready for some good clean-ish sort of fun. Now, you may have noticed I am standing in front of a cemetery, which shall remain nameless. So this evening, we will be performing for the living and the dead. So, without further ado, may I present to you the first act of the evening. By day, they're known as Katherine and Leah. And by night, they're known as Pure and Weary. Ladies and gentlemen, may I present Pure and Weary.
Thrice the blinded cat hath mewed.
Thrice and once the hedge pig whined.
My boyfriend said that I look fine. Tis time!
Round about the cauldron go. I had a date who didn't show. Ate two burritos on my own. Brought some hot sauce for this spell. Now he's going to rot in hell.
Double toil and trouble. Fire burning.
Whoa, wait a minute. Is this the guy from your grandma's nursing home?
Yeah, the physical therapist.
Oh, no text?
No.
No explanation?
Nope.
No guac on your burrito?
Nope.
Heathens! Double toil and trouble, fire burn and cauldron bubble. Fillet of a fenny snake in the cauldron, boil and bake. Eye of a guy who used the wrong there, set fire to his unkempt hair. And he who talks throughout all movies, infect him with these icky cooties. Double toil and trouble.
All three of those dudes were this week?
Yup.
And they were all bad?
Yup.
And you had to go home alone and light candles and put on Enya and do your own?
Whoa. Yup.
It's time to make a good man.
First, let's start with empathy and a solid memory.
I'm allergic to peanuts.
Yeah, so seriously, she doesn't want that Reese's cup, okay?
I know you're human, so you sometimes smell, but the sound of your video games is a living hell.
Yeah, I'm so glad those Dr. Dre Beats headphones are working so well for you.
Those were really expensive.
For a charm of powerful trouble, like a hell broth boil and bubble, give us a man who hath no flaws.
Powers that be support our cause.
He's here.
Makes sense.
Yeah, sure does.
Weren't Pure and Weary wonderful? They're hilarious, and I am proud to be able to call them my friends. For more information on them and upcoming performances, you can check out their YouTube channel, Facebook page, and Instagram. Currently, they're producing a breast cancer awareness benefit show that's on October 29th at Stage 773. For more information on that, check it out on Facebook. Look, I don't know about you, but every month of October, sometimes I see a hand reaching towards my face or hear a faint whisper of someone calling my name. And look, I know I'm not crazy. So to take care of this little nuisance, well, I put a dash or even a dollop of the mixing mix into my adult beverage of choice, which happens to be whiskey. Now, this will also work in vodka, gin, rum, tequila, and even for you lightweights, amaretto. All better. Okay, moving right along to the next act. He's a very magical man. He was the headliner all through the month of September for Chicago's Magic Lounge. Ladies and gentlemen, it's Bibik.
Good evening, everyone. Great to be back on Late Night Binder. My name is Bibik the Magician. My job, of course, is magic, and in magic, we deal in illusions. An illusion is where you think you see something happening, but really, nothing is happening at all. Allow me to demonstrate with these three pieces of rope. As you can see, I have a short piece of rope. You can tell because the ends are very close together. I have a medium piece of rope in which the ends are further apart, and I have a long piece of rope. That's the longest one of them all. Now, I wonder if somebody in the audience could examine these pieces of rope for me. How about you? Thank you very much. Perfect. Now, watch carefully, ladies and gentlemen. As I said before, I deal in illusions. Allow me to explain. You see, I have a long piece of rope, as I said. I have a short piece of rope and one medium piece of rope. Now, the object of this illusion is to make it appear as if all of those ropes are of exactly the same length. To do that, I even up all of the ends. Once all of the ends are evil, even or evil, then it's a simple matter to even up the middle. Now I have three pieces of rope that are exactly the same length. You see, there's a piece, and there's a piece, and there's a piece too. Now, of course, as I said before, if I do have three even pieces of rope, I should be able to do the math and come up with six even ends and three even centers. Let me see if that is the case. Here we go. One, two, three, four, five. Indeed, six even ends, three even centers. But I did mention ideal and illusions, ladies and gentlemen. That's all an illusion, you see. I have only a short piece of rope, a medium piece of rope, and one long piece of rope. Thank you. For my next mystery, I'd like to invite someone from the audience. Miss, how about you? Thank you so much. A nice round of applause. Thank you very much. Why, it's Amee herself. Thanks for having me on again, Amee. Great to be back.
Glad to have you.
I couldn't help but notice what the beautiful earrings you have today for the Halloween season. Is that a beautiful pumpkin? What exactly is that?
I believe it's an
emerald.
Wait a minute.
What is that? Okay, that's not a pumpkin. That is very strange. From your bathtub or something like that?
Yeah.
Very strange indeed. Here, I'll tell you what. Try a little bit of magic. I'll push down on the sponge and I'll try to cut it in two. This is kind of crazy. Try to cut it in two. Let's see if I can cut it in two. Oh my goodness. It's weird, isn't it? Now here's the strange thing. If I hold on to this one in my left hand and this one in my right hand, watch what happens. Did you see it? It disappears. It doesn't actually disappear. It goes up my sleeve, across my shoulders, down my arm, and I catch it over here when you're not looking. Here, try it again. Hold your hand out. That's perfect. Look, I'll hold on to this one in my left hand. You hold on to this one in your right hand. All right? From left to right, close it around. Take your other hand, put it on top. That's perfect. I'll wave the magic wand, and believe it or not, it's gone. Did you feel it leave you? Did you feel anything? Unbelievable. Open up your hand. Oh, my goodness. Wow. You are really good. Would you like to try it again?
Okay.
How about if we try it backwards?
Sure.
I'll give you both of the balls, so hold them both together like this, all right?
Okay.
Take both of the balls in both hands. Lock your fingers together.
Okay.
Lock your fingers together. That's perfect. And squeeze as hard as you can. Now, believe it or not, those balls are going to leave her hand and travel across the ether into my hand. Watch carefully.
Oh, my gosh.
There's the first one. There's the second one. Let me make sure I have them both. Yeah, there they are. Now, that's the easy part, of course. The hard part is to make them go back to Amee's hand. And look, they're gone. Did you feel them leave your hand?
Yeah.
Do you see? Did you feel them go back in your hand?
Yeah.
Told ya. Do you have both of the balls?
I think maybe.
Take a look. Wait a second. Wait a minute. Oh, wow. Oh, boy.
Whoa.
Wow. Oh, wow. I don't know how to tell you this, but lady, you got a lot of balls. Oh, boy. Well, I have a nice prize for you for helping out today anyway. It's your very own cocktail napkin. I want you to take this home and enjoy it at your leisure. Wait a second. Perhaps it's something else. Uh-huh. Watch very carefully. If I wrap this around my fingers like so, and then give it a little twist, it turns into something very, very unusual. Wait a minute. Do you see it? I think I see it. Is it possible?
I guess it
was all of those years of twisting those small squares of paper. They have finally paid off for me. There is a beautiful flower for our host. And here is the best part. Are you ready? The best part is... Oh, it smells just like a napkin. That's for you.
Oh, Bibik.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Good night, everyone.
You know you all know the story of Frankenstein.
So we won't be retelling that, but... What if instead of one body, there were three?
And instead of masculine body parts, they were feminine.
And instead of being programmed with basic human functions, they were programmed with dance moves and showgirl behavior.
Oh my God. I think that's what happened.
Yeah, you're right. Look over there.
Franken showgirls.
Shit out every tear. students for me.
Walk into a haunted house and a zombie jumps out and you crap your pants? Well, look no further than Mixing Mix for all your pooping stains. Now Halloween can be fun again. Up next, your favourite funny man with the wiener and the mustard, Matt Ulrich.
Hey America, it's me, your favourite comedian, Matt. It's been a while since we've seen each other. I'm well, and I hope you are too. I brought a friend along, Reaper. Everybody say hello to Reaper. Great. So, hey Reaper, what did you think of those ladies from earlier? Yeah, me too. They really did something for me as well. I'm sorry, that was inappropriate for children of all ages. So Reaper and I, we've been traveling all across the country, telling all sorts of Halloween-themed jokes. I mean, would you guys like to hear us tell Halloween jokes? It's made us lots of money. I mean, yes, you would. Thank you very much. So what do you call a hot dog with no wiener in it? A Halloweener. Hey, so what do Australians dress up as for Halloween? Boomerangs. So what did the skeleton, when the skeleton went to the dance, who did he bring? Nobody. So when witches go to school, what's the most important class that they have to take? spelling. It's because witch can be spelled two different ways. You got it now. When writers have writer's block around Halloween, who do they hire? Ghost writers. Actually, ghost writers are a burden on the creative industry. So, hey Reaper, what are you gonna be for Halloween? Reaper's gonna be drunk. But seriously, be safe out there and drink responsibly. Let's see what the internet has for jokes. Why didn't the skeleton want to go to school? His heart wasn't in it. Why did the skeleton cross the road? To get to the body shop. What did the little girl say when she had to choose between a tricycle or a trip to the candy bar? Trike or treat. What room does a ghost not need? A living room. And finally, what do you call a fat pumpkin? A plumpkin. Thank you all so much. That was my comedy. How would you like to see some impressions? That would be great. Here's my impression of a vampire. And here's my impression of Frankenstein. And finally, I have to prepare for this one. Here's my impression of the Wolfman. Thank you all so much. And now, for your enjoyment, please give it up for the world famous Pure and Weary.
Donaldson, come in, please.
Hi.
Listen, I'm not gonna beat around the tombstone, Donaldson. You haven't scared anybody in a month.
I'm sorry.
I don't want you to be sorry. I want you to get better. I thought for sure you'd be all over your ex-boyfriend. I mean, he moved in with that girl that he left you for a week after you died. We basically handed that to you on a silver coffin.
I know, but I did scare them, remember, in the attic?
Oh, Donaldson, boo and hoo are the international words for crying, even for a ghost.
I was really sad.
It's okay to be sad. Use it. That's what fuels us. That anger and our ghostly white sheets. And while we're on the subject, what is with the glitter?
Plain white makes me look fat.
Donaldson, when's the last time you even looked in a mirror, huh? We can't. No reflections. Did you learn nothing in the afterlife?
Just because I can't see myself doesn't mean I shouldn't look pleasant for other people.
The uniform is standard, Donaldson. Simple white sheet. It's comfortable. People recognize it. It's the best thing since sliced heads. I can't have you floating around looking like Liberace, okay? And by the way, Liberace wears the white sheets.
Okay, fine. I'll wear the plain white sheet.
I can't keep saving your soul, Donaldson. We got 100 ghosts lining up around the crypt just aching for a shot at your beat. If you can't come up with some scares, then we're gonna have to transfer you to accounts regrievable with Mary.
No, not the Virgin. She's such a prude.
I like you, Donaldson. You're a good ghoul. But this is your last chance, okay? Spook or get off the plot.
Okay, I promise I'll be better. I'll cut the who from the boo.
Good.
I'll just whisper it ever so quietly to myself.
No, Donaldson!
Okay, I'm sorry. I'll say it right. And I'll wear the plain white sheet.
That's all I ask.
I'll just have a little white ribbon to cinch my waist.
A Mary!
No, okay! I'll wear it just like everybody else.
Thank you.
I look so fat. Boo! Who?
Donaldson!
I'm sorry.
Hey, Nicole.
Yeah?
Remember in the last episode when Sam Brown the Clown's partner didn't show up?
Yes! And one of our showgirls, Andria, jumped in as his partner?
Yeah, the act was super adorable.
It was.
I know, it was hard to believe that they never met before.
Yeah, they hardly knew each other.
I know, strangers. Anywho, what? Turns out they really liked working with each other.
No!
Yes!
Oh!
And they came back for this episode.
Yay!
I know.
Oh my god!
Ladies and gentlemen, Sam Brown the Clown.
And partner, Andria Emerick.
Everyone, America, it's your old pal Matt again, and I'm back with my friend Reaper. We'd like to tell you about one of our favorite products, Mixy Mix. That's right, Mixing Mix. This Halloween, if you're trying to scare away the ghouls, make sure you reach for some Mixing Mix. Just sprinkle some on every entryway to your home and or condominium apartment, and it'll keep the ghouls away. Plus, it makes a great casserole. That's right. This Halloween, reach for Mixing Mix. I'm sorry, Reaper, my friend. I shouldn't have dropped you on the ground like that. Hey, Reaper and friends, it's come to that time of night when we've reached the last act. A little backstory. So many years ago, there were five showgirls studying witchcraft and spellbook behaviors within their classroom. And that classroom went up in flames. And none of the girls made it out alive. Sometimes they say, in big enough fires and flames, you can see their faces flaming. In a super rare occurrence, a seance was held last night. And we got them to come back and do a performance for one night only. Ladies and gentlemen, show ghouls.
I put a spell on you. Because you're mine. Stop the things you do. What's up?
much for tuning in to Late Night Vendor, a Halloween variety show. A special thank you to all of the spooktacular performers this evening. A great thank you to the crew, and a gigantic thank you to our sponsor, the Mixing Mix. Ooh. Have a great evening. Happy Halloween.
Goodbye.
Series.